Ladies and gents, hello and welcome. My name, of course, is Orbital Potato, and here we check out the latest and the greatest strategy games each and every day of the week. Today, we're turning our attention to trains, planes, and automobiles of all shapes and sizes. From railways to rockets, we're having a look at the best upcoming transport management games out there. I love me some logistics, and there's nothing more satisfying than setting up a vehicle supply route, and we're showcasing some of the best games that let you do just that. However, if city builders are more your style, then check out the video linked in the description below and also on screen right now. I hope we've got a few games on this list that you've not heard of, but we've also got a few games that you can play right now, so make sure you stick around for the whole list to get the lowdown. Let's get to the games. Station to Station is a beautifully created transport game in which you start with a few small rural structures and have to connect them up by way of rails and trains. Place stations and establish connections to grow and expand your transport network. The more you build, the more the area grows, bringing with it spectacularly designed voxel art biomes. You can put your transport management skills to the test with various challenges, bonus, and unique mechanics that come with each biome. You've got the option to take it easy and relax, fulfilling basic objectives, or push your logistics network to the max and fulfill all the objectives. The Station to Station demo dropped earlier this year, and I checked it out, linked in the top right-hand corner of the screen right now if you're interested. I'm super excited for this one, which is set to launch later on October 3rd, 2023. I'm really hoping that the full release build adds a whole bunch of freedom and flexibility to the game, as it's quite linear at the moment. There's nothing wrong with that. I'd just love to see some more open-ended logistics challenges. Next is a game that I think everyone is waiting for. This is, of course, the sequel to the hugely successful Cities Skylines. It is, of course, Cities Skylines 2, and it promises to be everything its predecessor was and so much more. Though not strictly a game exclusively about transport, transport is an absolutely critical component to ensuring the city of your dreams is not only a reality, but a success. Ensuring your residents are able to beat the morning rush hour traffic by building efficient highways or reliable railways will fuel your city's growth. Connecting your harbors and airports by rail and road will guarantee that freight makes it to and around your city. Without good transport options and infrastructure, no city can grow. And transportation infrastructure is going to be an even bigger part of the sequel, with a whole new AI car and driver system, and I can't wait to hear more about this in the weeks and months ahead before launch. I don't think I need to say much more about how excited I am for this one. The developers are slowly drip-feeding us more and more information, and it really feels very tortuous, but you know, we'll get there. Cities Skylines 2 will be arriving on the 24th of October this year, and as I've said previously, it will be one that I will certainly be checking out. Up next is another sequel that's soon to be steaming into the station. Railroad Corporation 2 is set during the early 20th century, just as rail electrification is arriving. In this one, you'll be building your railroad empire as you evolve from steam locomotives to new diesel and electric engines. Establish cities with various industries and amenities to help grow your empire. These cities will need powered, as will your locomotives, so connect the region by rail to boost trade and grow your corporation. Over time, you'll be able to deliver improvements that will drive ever greater efficiency. And of course, time is money, and the new diesel and electric technology is your key to success. Improve your railroads with faster locomotives and greater efficiency. Unlock additional resources through research and discover groundbreaking ways to develop the landscape. Become the most reliable and prosperous railroad corporation to outpace the competition. We don't have a release date yet for this one, but if you're unable to wait, you can play the original whilst you're waiting for the sequel to release. Ground of Aces is a base-building game that lets you take command of a remote airbase of workers and pilots during World War II. Whether in campaign timelines or in a never-ending free-build mode, you plan, build, and shape your very own airbase, and need to take care of all inhabitants during mankind's biggest conflict, and defend it when it's under attack. Farm resources, grow food, and manage your supplies well. It is your job to be prepared once the war turns dire. How much will you be able to harvest yourself? What will you trade with nearby villages? And how dependent will you be on shipments from command? It's all in your hands. play around with a bunch of era-specific aircraft, including the Spitfire and Hurricane, all with a gorgeous comic book art style. This is one of my most anticipated upcoming games, and I really can't wait for further details. At the moment, all we know from the successful Kickstarter project is that the developers are aiming for a playable alpha by the end of 2023, with early access hopefully coming in fall of 24. Marshal the troops, because I think this is gonna be a good one. Airborne Empire is a city builder and management game rolled into one. You'll build a city in the sky and pilot it across a gorgeous landscape, collecting the resources you need to survive from down below. It's the sequel to the incredible and critically acclaimed Airborne Kingdom, which I thoroughly enjoyed. In Airborne Empire, you'll be traversing a vast and rich open world full of new dangers, exotic wonders, and many hidden treasures. The unique lift, balance, and propulsion mechanics return, but a new foe has emerged. Pirates upend the city's tranquility, and players must defend their inhabitants and the kingdoms below from destructive attacks. Only clever and daring leaders can grow and protect their homes, seek out and destroy enemy strongholds, and finally, reunite the peoples of this world. This one will be coming sometime in 2024, and I'm super excited to see what it brings to the table. Absolutely one to watch. Railgrade is a train resource management game in which you construct dense rail networks, develop cities, and expand industrial production, all on story-driven maps. It's actually available over on Epic right now, but it's coming to Steam real soon. In Railgrade, you'll construct intricate and complicated railway networks to connect industry to the resources they demand, optimize your production, and establish efficient supply chains with multi-level tracks and various locomotives that you can customize in a number of ways. There's a huge amount of missions to complete as you help restore an industrial colony and win over your corporate overlords, as the developers describe, to be permitted to return to Earth. When I played this one, it was an incredibly polished game. It was really, really good looking, and it slowly introduces more mechanics as you progress through the game. It is really, really good. It's expected to release on Steam sometime later this year in 2023, and hopefully there are a bunch of Steam upgrades and overhauls that means I'll be able to check it out again. Take to the skies with the crew of a bomber over the skies of occupied Europe in B-17 Squadron. Take command of each crew member as you destroy targets below. From piloting the aircraft or navigating and communicating from the radio operator's room, there's loads of tasks to complete to ensure that the mission is successful. Afterward, fly your way home safely, which might be easier said than done. You'll need to stay on your toes as you contend with anti-aircraft guns and Messerschmitts whilst managing fuel, ammunition, bombs, and oxygen supplies. This game looks quite thematically similar to U-Boat, where, you guessed it, you managed a submarine rather than a B-17 squadron. If this game is anything like U-Boat, however, I'd be very happy indeed, as I enjoyed my time with that game tremendously. No news yet on a release date for this one, so wishlist the game and keep your eyes peeled. So this next game is actually already out in early access, but it's excellent and constantly receiving updates, so I thought it warranted mentioning. Voxel Tycoon is a management sim set in the infinite voxel world. Mine resources and process them into goods in your custom factories. Set up supply chains and passenger routes with huge fleets of trains, trucks, and buses, and turn small towns into prosperous megacities with a thriving economy. This is such an excellent transport tycoon game. It draws a bunch of inspiration from the obvious classics, but it's also got some pretty funky and fresh automation and factory building elements. Basically, you'll end up building a massive transport network as well as a pretty huge network of factories too. It's really good, and of course, it's got a super sharp, voxely looking art style, which I think perfectly complements this game. Honestly, it's a great game that I really think is a hidden gem in the transport management space. Definitely give it a try if you're looking to scratch that itch right now. No word yet on when it's going to hit full release, but I'll absolutely keep you posted. Mars Horizon 2, The Search for Life, is an authentic space management game where you take on the role of the head of a space agency on your mission to search for life. Search for evidence across the solar system to prove there's life on other planets. Manage your staff, build your bases, design and launch rockets, and plan missions. You'll be writing a brand new space history every time you play. From the comfort of mission control, you'll guide your agency through the solar system to look for signs of life, gather evidence of fossils, microbes, unusual atmospheres, minerals, molecular structures, energy, disequilibrium, and more. This is a distinctly more serious rocket management game than Kerbal Space Program, and it looks like you're able to take a pretty top-down approach to managing and running everything a multi-planetary rocket agency requires. I'm really looking forward to this one and can't wait to start exploring the solar system and start sending missions off to far-flung planets. Get subscribed if you want to see more of this one when it comes out in 2024. In Capital Command, you take to the helm of an epic warship as you travel through space and take on foes in this sandbox campaign. Upgrade your ship, master the helm, and make use of your tactical abilities to overcome threats. Your crew follows your every order, from navigators, gunners, repair teams, and engineers, as you control the cumbersome vessel with its expansive arsenal. You'll find that ships move realistically, and that as you navigate the stars, you'll need to both take on and embrace inertia. Capital Command is full of really cool features, like being able to spot opponents from hundreds of kilometers away, allowing you to plan your attack to isolate and outmaneuver them. There's loads of weapon systems for you to make use of, such as solid projectile artillery, missile pods, and point defense turrets with the scope to use salvage resources, and to repair and upgrade your vessel. Capital Command will challenge you to think ahead of your enemy whilst constantly outnumbered. As captain, it all rests on your shoulders, and you'll be able to take to the helm sometime next year in 2024. Automation Station is a game about, you guessed it, automation. Starting off with nothing, you'll quickly discover raw resources for you to collect, refine, and craft into the machines necessary to automate your tasks. Eventually, you'll be able to link up your machines with conveyor belts and other gadgets to create large automated assembly lines. As you scale up, you'll unlock more areas of the world to find new resources and machines to improve and expand your factory. Expand your assembly lines with conveyor belts and a whole bunch of other tech. You can build your factory however you want, super efficiently, or perhaps a patchwork of chaos, whatever works for you. This game looks great. It's quirky and it is graphically stunning, so I really can't wait to share more details on this one with you in the future. Absolutely subscribe if you're interested in seeing it. Automation Station is still in early development and the developer is still to announce a release date. However, you can keep up to date with the development on the Steam page or on the Discord and help shape this game's future. The premise for this one is strange. Recovering from uncertain times, your peeps find themselves on the back of Kiwa, a lonely space whale journeying across the universe. Building a city on the back of a sentient creature comes with its own set of challenges, but as you build your relationship and travel across the galaxy, you'll come across great opportunities for exploration and stable expansion. Meet other species, pursue the needs and wants of your peeps, and seek the truth about their ancestors and the space whales alike. This is Beyond These Stars, and it's a sequel to Before We Leave, which also featured space whales. It remains to be seen just how much logistical management this game features, but given that it's on the back of a space whale, I'm going to make the assumption that there is at least some, even if it is primarily rocket-based. This is absolutely one that I'll be checking out when it releases, as I love me some city building action, and if it features some logistics systems, then that's all for the better. So far, no word on a release date quite yet, but it's arriving sometime in 2024, so hopefully not too long to wait. Mini Settlers is a minimalistic city builder and logistic network builder. Settle islands, construct cities, and design efficient networks to fulfill your building's needs, and fuel population growth to adventure into new worlds. Build a well-connected network of roads, trains, and ports between your factories and cities to transport and fulfill any need they may have. But be careful not to overload your supply chain. Use your transport infrastructure to build ever greater cities and unlock increasingly more complex buildings and research objectives. This really is much more of a logistics and supply capacity game than a city builder. So if you're into that sort of thing, make sure you wishlist it. I checked out an early build of this linked up in the top right-hand corner right now, which is available as a demo right now. Click the link down in the description if you are interested in checking that out. This one is a bit of a no-brainer for me. Workers and Resources Soviet Republic is the ultimate real-time Soviet-themed city builder transport tycoon game. Construct your own republic and transform a poor country into a rich industrial superpower. To do this, you'll need vehicles, a lot of them. Trains, planes, and lots of automobiles. Manage all aspects of your own republic with planned economy, including mining resources, manufacturing goods, constructing buildings, investing in everything, and also managing your citizens as well. Create your own industrial complexes with loading and unloading stations, storage, warehouses, and factories. Build all the infrastructure and manage its traffic, including roads, railways, sidewalks, conveyors, wiring, and pipelines. Wisely place and connect factories, houses, and warehouses, and make the most efficient connections possible. This is honestly an excellent game that you can play right now. It's currently in early access, but honestly, the amount of content in this game is staggering. There's also a whole bunch of mods available as well. You could play this game for hundreds and hundreds of hours, as I have, and still find a whole bunch of brand new features and ways to appreciate it. It's getting regular updates, no idea when a full release is coming, but don't let that stop you from diving into this one if you like really, really, really long rail networks and a whole bunch of other great stuff. Train Valley World welcomes you to the heart of the Industrial Revolution. The newest entry in a beloved management sim franchise evolves the Train Valley experience by adding deeper tycoon mechanics to the staple railway puzzle gameplay formula. Travel across the world to build and manage efficient railroads, create your own maps with a robust level editor, and join other players in online multiplayer. All aboard! This looks to be a lovely, casual little train builder with a bunch of multiplayer options too, which is always nice. I have no idea how long it'll give you in terms of playtime and replayability, but if you want to lay some track with friends, then get this wishlisted as it is coming to Steam next year in 2024. Another even more casual rail building game. Islands and Trains is a relaxing sandbox building game. Build tiny dioramas with just one shed or idyllic villages with dense forests. Lay your own railroad on top of your beloved island, place animals in the countryside, and just watch and enjoy your peaceful creation. Get lost in finding the most perfect place for all these little pieces. No goals, no timer, no missions, no stress. Just happy accidents. Build, relax, enjoy. Whilst I personally think that I'd rather have an objective to build towards, I'd be interested to hear your comments on whether or not this is something that you're looking for in a logistics game. There's a demo of this game right now that has been live in the past and probably will be live in the future, so check out the link in the description to wishlist it and stay up to date. There's no word on a formal release date yet, but I'll try and keep you up to date. Hop into the driver's seat of your rocket-powered big rig as you haul cargo, scavenge for salvage, and interact with an eclectic cast of star-hopping truckers in this Americana-infused journey on the ultimate open road, space. Plan your routes along hyperhighways of a vibrant galaxy filled with opportunity. Invest your hard-earned cash in new components and essential supplies to keep your trusted truck firing on all cylinders and ready for the next challenge. Star Trucker is a hauling and space cargo management game, and I'm quite hyped for this one, but honestly, there's just not that much information to go on. There's just not that much information available. It's arriving in 2024. But that's pretty much all that we really know with regards to a release date. This is a very weird logistics management game. Trackline Express is a train builder where you need to reach subsequent stations whilst keeping your passengers safe from attacks and wildfires. Gather wood, rocks, ores, and coal, and then transform them into various resources to create new buildings and equipment using blueprints that you unlock along the way. Along your journey, you build up your train, adding more sophisticated carriages with additional capabilities at each and every stop. Level up your buildings and tools to extract more resources and drag your train towards the next station. This is an excellent little game. It's super fast-paced and super strategic, and I really enjoyed the time that I spent with the demo. Video linked up in the top right-hand corner, by the way. There's no word on a release date yet, but I am 100% interested in this one when it comes out. It's going to be great. Falling Frontier is a sci-fi RTS where ship design, recon, and logistics are critical elements. Your expeditionary force has just completed construction of its first spaceport in orbit of a new world. But you're not alone. Rival from the old colonial wars between Earth, Titan, Venus, and the other lineages that divide humankind have also arrived in the same star system. Wars are won or lost through logistics. A weaker opponent can choose to engage in guerrilla warfare, raiding supply depots and refineries, blockading colonies, and otherwise attacking each point in the enemy supply chain. Likewise, a stronger force cannot simply combine their ships into a single massive and unstoppable fleet, but must instead strategically distribute defensive flotillas throughout their territory. This game seems to be more than just logistics. It looks to have a bunch of deep combat, line-of-sight targeting systems, and I'm really excited for that. But I'm more excited for the potential to manage a galactic distribution network. Maybe that makes me sad, I don't know, but I can't wait. This one is arriving in hyperspace near you at some point in 2023, but no word yet on a firm release date. Perhaps I've saved the best until last. Factorio is finally getting some DLC, and we finally know more details about it. Revealed in a developer blog recently, Factorio DLC will be called Space Age. The too long didn't read of this is more Factorio, but in space, which means more logistics and much more factory building. I'm, of course, down for both. There really is, at the time of writing anyway, painfully few details available about this expansion. Most are undoubtedly coming, but we do now know a time frame. It's planned for release in August of 2024, or thereabouts. I truthfully suspect that it's going to get pushed back just a little bit. Factorio is one of my all-time favorite games, so I'm super hyped for this DLC, but I also can't wait for more details to be released. It is going to be so darned good. So that's it, ladies and gents. What is the game that you're looking most forward to? I would be very interested to hear in the comments down below. Have I missed anything? Have I missed an obvious transport game? A game that features a whole bunch of vehicles that I really should have added to this list, but just didn't? A logistical oversight, if you'd like. Please do let me know in the comments down below. I would love to hear your thoughts so that hopefully, if I'm able to make a follow-up video, if I do make a follow-up video, I'm able to include the game that you have suggested in that list. Also, if you're interested in helping make videos like this possible, do consider checking out the Patreon page, linked on screen right now and also down in the description below. But that's it for me, ladies and gents. I will see you next time.